Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, and in today's WordPress video, I'm going to talk about how to move your custom logo on your page, right? So in my previous video, I had talked about how to place your custom logo and how to resize it by using a small CSS code. And in today's video, we will see how we can move it to the right or left, how to position your logo on your web page. But before that, I have to mention something, because some of you guys find these solutions useful and some others don't. And I will also explain the reason why some of you guys are not actually able to work these out on your own WordPress themes. Right, okay, so before long do, let me explain how to get this particular method done. So we have two websites here. This is where I will demonstrate our solution. And this other one is for comparison reasons. Now, how do I move my custom logo around? I navigate to, first of all, I open up my WordPress admin console. And then I will navigate to appearance and not themes, but customize, right? This is where I will customize my theme and how it looks like. So here is my custom logo. This is a very simplistic theme. And actually it's a free one that's called 2020, right? So this actually comes with the WordPress installation, right? It's very basic, it just gets the job done. You will probably be working with some other theme, but this is where I will demonstrate. And there's a reason to it, okay? And I'll explain that further down in the video. Right, so what did we do in our last video? We placed this custom logo, and with some additional CSS code, we resized this and made it larger or smaller, right? Before we continue, please take a couple of seconds to give a thumbs up to this video, and it will help a lot to support my channel. Thank you very much. Now, where is our small code from the previous video? It's here, right? So we used this one to manipulate the size of our custom logo. All right, now you can see that we use the logo's metadata, the name, the object name, and then we changed the attribute that's called max height, right? Now we can add actually some other attributes to this, such as position, and we can say absolute. See what it does? It actually detaches your logo from this banner. You see, now it's become independent. Now it's inside. Now it's independent. See? Now, as you can see, with this attribute, we can make it much larger, much larger, or much smaller. So let's say that 150 is our size. Now, the attribute to actually move this logo to the right would be padding. And then it would be padding left. And this would be, let's say, 100. So, the attribute to move your logo further to the right would be padding left and say 200 pixels. Why left? Because I'm leaving space, this much space from the left. Okay? So, because actually it's It's leaning to the left, right? The logo is placed on the left side of my page, that I will leave this much space before my logo starts. That this is what it means. Padding means that I'm leaving this much space before my object can start. Okay? So you can actually change this or make it even smaller. And this tells you how to move the logo to further to the right. All right? Now, do not use padding top, because this is something completely different. This will actually change the size of your logo. Okay? So, see, my logo is gone. 50. You see, now this actually has a completely different effect. Without this, my logo is the size that I have set this, and now this is diminishing. This is decreasing the size of my custom logo. All right. So I would say just avoid this, because you're actually setting the size of your custom logo with this attribute, and then with padding left, you're moving this further to the right. And again, with position absolute, you're detaching this from the header. So visually speaking, that's what it does, okay? And without this, your logo would move, would expand the header so that it fits inside. But without this, your header lives its own life without taking into account the size of your custom logo. Now, why this code works in some themes and it doesn't work with others? The reason is not every WordPress theme allows you to manipulate logos, right? So I'll show you how. Now, this is another website. This is my main website, which is admintutorial.com, and I'm using another theme here, which is Pressbook Dark. And let's go and try to customize this using the same code. Now, obviously, this is a completely different theme, and it doesn't necessarily allow me to change or modify the same aspects, the same attributes of my website. Okay? So if I go to the same location, say I navigate to additional CSS, see, I have no CSS code at this moment applied to my theme, but I will do so. I'll copy this over and then paste it here. Right. So please observe, some things worked and some others didn't. What worked? For example, position absolute worked. And you can observe that padding worked, but the size did not work. See, 400, 600, it's doing nothing. Okay? So this is very important for you to note, because not every theme is going to allow you to change every attribute. So that this is why it's absolutely important when you're first choosing the theme to apply to your website, you have to make sure that it allows the things that you want to modify on your website. Okay? So if this attribute is absolutely vital to you and you really want to go with a free theme, you don't want to use this one, because this is not allowing you to change the size of your custom logo. Whereas this one absolutely does. I can just say 450 and this attribute works. So see, there's nothing wrong with the code. It's just the theme, either it allows you to manipulate this attribute or it doesn't, right? Okay, so this is the reason why this type of CSS code will work for some of you guys, and it's not going to have any effect at all for others. And this is because of the theme that you're using. So how can you get past that, actually? So what you can do is when you're selecting a theme, you can make sure that it allows you to manipulate custom logos. Say, for example, appearance, themes, and you want to add new, right? So you have a feature filter here. What you can do is you can narrow down the choices by selecting custom logo. Also, maybe custom header, custom colors. So this all depends on what attribute you want to change and modify in the standard free theme that comes with this installation, right? So make sure that you have the custom logo, and otherwise, I mean, it's not going to, some of the themes, they won't even let you add your own logo, right? Well, I hope this video has been useful. So again, what we have done is we have covered the CSS code that we use to move our logo around on the page to the right or to the left. So that's something that we achieve with the padding command. And we've also talked about the position. Again, a reminder, so this is detaching and attaching our logo to the header. And then we talked about why sometimes this these manipulations works, they work in some themes and they don't work in others. Right, so guys, I'll appreciate if you can give a thumbs up, a like to this video to support this channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. If you can just take a couple of seconds to give a thumbs up, a like to this video, I'll appreciate it. It will help a lot. And see you in the next video.